Hey friends, cloud environments created by Azure Landing Zones, that's part of the cloud adoption framework, are all built from the same common design elements: networking, identity, resource organization, and more. But while commonalities exist across all environments, each landing zone implementation is customized to support a specific type of structure or cloud operating model. Brian Blanchard is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Brian Blanchard and we're going to talk about Azure Landing Zones. I don't know what it is, but it sounds awesome. What a great name.
Thanks, Scott. Yep, Azure Landing Zones are a big passion of ours inside of the Cloud Adoption Framework and something we use to really help accelerate customers' adoption curves. And love the opportunity to talk about them here on Azure Friday.
Absolutely. So when we think about governance, when you talk about like preparing and constraining the cloud so that it meets our business needs, it matches our risk models and things like that. But when I think of as landing zone, I think about a helicopter, you know, landing in an area of a circle of some kind, whether it be the top of a hospital or, you know, in MASH in the middle of a war. Am I thinking right when I think about a landing zone?
On the surface, yeah. But there's a lot more to it. So for you to be able to land there, you've already got to have governance in place and operational management and security and other strategic elements in place. Otherwise, it's a little harder to land a helicopter in the middle of a jungle that hasn't been mowed down and properly prepared.
So that's actually that's a funny analogy, actually. You're right, because the prep work made the landing for the helicopter pilot easy, because they're going to land and they're going to look how amazing I am. I made a virtual machine in the cloud. That was easy. I'm, you know, pat, pat, pat. But the prep work, the jungle was prepared for the LZ. That is a great analogy. Thank you for that.
Yeah, no, thank you. Yeah, and when the landing zone isn't done right, it's really hard for our adoption teams to go out and build great things and launch new innovations or migrate what's in their data center, because later on they're going to run into governance or security. So if we have a little bit of collaboration up front, we put some design in and we prepare the environment for them, they feel like heroes because they get to come in and not run into that friction.
Okay, so a landing zone, an Azure landing zone, is a tangible thing. This is not just words on a page. It is there's a definite preparation. There's a plan in place that turns into resource groups and networks and real things in Azure.
Yes, sir, there is.
All right.
And there's actually a couple of options.
Let's learn all about it.
Sounds great. So in the last sessions on Cloud Adoption Framework, we've talked about things like governance. Well, readiness comes a little bit earlier, and it's more part of getting ready to go forward and migrate or innovate in the cloud. So in the ready methodology, we talk about that environmental readiness. And if you do this right, then governance and management aren't as hard for you, nor is adoption, migration, innovation, any of those. So an Azure landing zone is that big X that you talked about. But it's also how the customer sets up their full environment so that they've got scale, security, governance, networking, identity, all of these other pieces, so that whether they're doing a migration or something net new, all those platform resources are there. And it doesn't matter if you're IaaS or PaaS, the teams can make those decisions on their own as they deploy the right technologies. So we do that, again, like you said, by taking care of a couple of key design areas, making sure that we've addressed things like how are you enrolling your enterprise? How do you set up identity? How do you tackle management groups and resource groups through resource organization? How do you connect your network topology and connect it back to on-prem? Have you considered operational baselines and setting up things like business continuity and disaster recovery? And have you implemented those governance disciplines that you need to meet any kind of compliance requirements? And then ultimately, what deployment option do you use to push all this out over and over again as people want to do a self-service environment or use an environment you've prepared for them? So it really helps the central IT team or the Cloud Center of Excellence team make sure that that environment's ready and that people can go forward with confidence and adopt what they need to.
That's a really good thing to say, that you said go forward with confidence, right? When you prep the LZ, you give the helicopter pilot the confidence, you give the team that wants to put their websites, put their virtual machines, put their workloads into Azure, the confidence to be able to do those things. And by prepping that space and continuing, I assume, to maintain that space so that they can do their work. Because it's not just an endpoint, right? You don't just prep the LZ and then leave.
Not at all. Yeah, the cloud adoption is a journey, as is development and maintenance of your Azure landing zones. And we actually have a couple of different models for landing zones, some that get you there faster, some that are more of a journey that you can do through a self-service model. And I'd love to share a little bit more about that, if that makes sense.
Absolutely.
So if you go into the cloud adoption framework under the Ready methodology, Azure landing zones start in this Azure landing zone tab. We talk about what they are. We also talk about some of the design areas, like we just talked about a second ago. But most importantly, we talk about the implementation options. Oh, that's the wrong tab there. There we go. Talk about the implementation options, which start with understanding what's your platform development velocity. Do you want to start with something that's enterprise scale and mold your operations to fit that defined architecture that we've put together? Or do you need to start with something smaller and expand it to specifically fit your operating model? And we've got a number of implementation options. So one's built on Azure Blueprints. That's the Cloud Adoption Framework's migration landing zone blueprint. So if you want to get going really fast to just migrate and you don't have a lot of compliance constraints, could be a good one for you. If you need to learn a little bit more about governance and compliance, the Foundation Blueprint starts by deploying some basic governance tools that you can then configure to meet your needs. And for open source purposes, down at the bottom here, we have Terraform modules that help you build out these same types of environments using a third-party tool set called Terraform. But then if you're really looking for that rich architecture and that solution that brings together security and governance and ops management and all of them, we've got a great in-state target called the Enterprise Scale Landing Zones that bring in all of these different architectures through one deployment. So it really depends on whether you want to start with that rich solution or you want to build your own to fit your own best of breed type of scenario and what fits your operating model best. So those are a couple of different implementation options we have available for people. And if we step into those, the blueprints here, if you're inside of the Azure portal, you can see both of these under Azure Blueprint as a new blueprint you could deploy. But if you look at the enterprise scale landing zones, you can actually deploy these right inside of the website from the GitHub repo. So each of the repos for that have a nice little deploy to Azure button that if you click through on that, it'll open up a page where you can actually configure your own deployment, pop in a few variables, and deploy out that enterprise scale landing zone into your subscription to automatically pick up the right Azure policy configurations, right security configurations. And all you really have to do is plug in what region you want to go into and a couple of other basic inputs to be able to deploy that environment out. And when you're done, you'll get something really rich that gives you a full set of architectures to protect your environment and give your development teams that big X that they can target for whatever they want to deploy.
So
Scott, does that help?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I'm curious if I do this, though, like I saw, for example, on that one, it was going to put in 19 resources, and then I see this diagram here. When you set down a path, are any of those paths locking you into any future path? Like, are you like I forked in the road and I went over here and now I'm stuck and I regret not picking this other path?
So we work really hard to avoid what we call no-cliff implementations. Hmm. So that if you choose one of these paths, you can very easily transition into another.
Nice.
The thing that's important, though, is understanding how you want to operate in the future. Because if you have that wrong, no amount of tooling change is going to save you. So we have a number of different operating models defined that people can reference to figure out what is the right way to go forward for them. And I'm just going to switch screens here. There we go. So understanding that operating model is probably more important than understanding the first path. Mm-hmm. Because if you want to be decentralized, you may not need a landing zone. But you're signing up for your development team to understand how to implement their own security and governance and operations requirements. If you're more central operations, meaning that only central IT has access to a production environment and dev test is done somewhere else, you may not need that enterprise scale type of solution. And you can start small and set some really tightly controlled operating controls and governance controls. But if you are looking for something that's really rich enterprise collaboration, where some environments are governed by central IT or central operations, others are governed and deployed in ways that encourage more innovation, then you might want that richer architecture. Very compatible with one another, but it's a matter of finding out how you want to operate and which one is going to get you to that operating state the fastest.
Very cool. That makes a lot of sense. and understanding what you're trying to accomplish up front, putting a little bit of planning and thought and not just hitting the deploy button and hoping that that's the perfect prescription is important. It's really nice that you call out the priorities and the scope and really the motivation for why someone's trying to do this. You point out that that cloud operating model is really driven by your strategic priorities and your organizational motivations.
Yes, sir. And collaboration between those teams. There's nothing more important in the cloud than making sure that your governance, your security, and your operations teams are collaborating, and that they're there to support those teams that are adopting new technologies.
Mm-hmm. And the cloud adoption framework that we talked about in another video that folks can check out, you validate that with customers, you talk to customers, you iterate on those things. These models, this landing zone model, is being used by customers all over the world, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah, we see this used thousands of times a month by customers through the blueprint model, and we're starting to see a significant uptick of the enterprise scale model being used as well. And they're then taking that and building on that to really fit the environment they need.
Fantastic.
And a lot of that comes from our partners. So we would love to take credit for that, but really it's a great bit of contribution across people in the field and our partners that come together to build this guidance and validate it. And that's represented a lot by those partner offers. So partners come in and put together offers around each of the methodologies of the cloud adoption framework. And the ones that are in the ready methodology, they've built out a landing zone offer that they're using to help customers go even faster, get to that point of having a rich, robust, ready landing zone for whatever they want to do.
Very cool. So folks can check all that out up at the cloud adoption framework and the landing zone pages. They can engage with a partner. The partners are going to know what landing zones are, and they're going to set them up for success.
Yes, sir. And you'll see a lot of the same terminology that you read in the self-service model coming through with what the partners say or even what our own employees say. So it helps create a consistent conversation for you.
Fantastic. Well, I'm very excited to go and help people prepare the LZ to bring in that helicopter and make their customers successful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
All right. I'm learning all about how to prepare my cloud environment using Azure Landing Zones today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.